Mighty Mountain and the Mustard Seed by Candace Alford, illustrated by Kate Witt. For Lucas, Evelyn, and Jane, my little mustard seeds, who move me in mighty ways every single day. Love always, Mom. For Marcus, my mighty mountain and better half, who keeps me grounded, encourages me, and never ceases to amaze me. Thank you for a love that only grows deeper and stronger with each passing day. Way up high through the clouds lived the mighty mountain. He was the tallest and boldest, no bigger mountain could be found. At the tippity top of the mighty mountain lived a family of mustard seeds. Each morning as the sun would peek out above the horizon, the mighty mountain would slowly wake from his slumber. On the other hand, the small family of mustard seeds would be up by morning's first glow, working hard. Even though they were small, the mustard seeds believed they could do big things. One beautiful day after a long morning of lounging, the mighty mountain yawned as the sun hit high noon. "Perfect time for a nap," he said, finishing up his yawn. As he settled in for a snooze, he was quickly disturbed by the pitter-patter of teeny tiny feet. Cracking open one eye to find the source of the annoyance, he squinted and strained his eyes. Finally, he spotted the youngest member of the little mustard seed family.
"You sure make a lot of noise for such a little seed," he bellowed, irritated by the interruption.
The seed stood between the eyes of the mighty mountain, grinning from ear to ear. "I'm sorry for the inconvenience, Mr. Mountain, sir, but I must work extra hard as I am the smallest in my family. A job that takes the others one day takes me 2 or sometimes 3 days to do." The mighty mountain let out an arrogant humph and barked,
"Too bad you're not as big and mighty as a mountain. All I have to do is sit here and people marvel at me."
Wide-eyed, the tiny seed was astonished. "You do nothing all day?" Proud of himself, the mighty mountain said,
"Yes, and I am still the biggest and strongest. There is no one more mighty than me."
Thinking through this newfound knowledge, the tiny seed said, deep from his heart, "Are you sure that's true?" Confused, the mighty mountain grumped,
"What do you mean?"
"Well, you are the biggest," said the seed, "but how sad that you'll never really grow." Befuddled, the mighty mountain scoffed,
"Why must I grow? I'm the biggest and strongest. Everybody knows."
With sad little eyes, the tiny seed said, "You are mighty in size, sir, that much is true. But what about your faith, Mr. Mountain?" Not liking the challenge, the mighty mountain roared,
"What is this faith you dare say I need? I'm the mighty mountain, you're just a tiny little seed."
"Yes, I am small, but I know of someone even more mighty than you."
"Impossible!" fired back the mighty mountain in rage. "Who could be more mighty than me?"
In a humble tone, the little mustard seed confirmed. "Well, it's God," Jesus said. "I tell you the truth, if you have faith even as small as a mustard seed, you could say to this mountain, 'Move from here to there,' and it would move. You see, it's not your gigantic size or that I'm a tiny seed that reveals the power inside of me. It's my trust in God and not myself that makes everything possible." Closing his eyes, the tiny young seed let out a sigh and fell to his knees. "Dear God, reveal your mighty power today. There is nothing too big, no request is too small. I have faith in you, Father. Please use every little bit of me." And what happened next, you wouldn't believe. That mighty mountain, the biggest of all, was lifted and moved by the tiniest seed. Up high in the sky, the mighty mountain stared in fascination at the tiny young seed holding him in the air. In that very second, everything the mustard seed had said became perfectly clear. From that moment on, the mighty mountain grew, not in size, but in his heart, as he knew the truth. That tiny young seed did a brave thing that day. He put his faith in the Lord and faced the mightiest mountain. His boldness and truth proved that absolutely nothing is impossible with God. If you ever feel like a small mustard seed up against a mighty mountain, just remember God's word and join me as I pray. Heavenly Father, I believe in you, that no matter my size or the mountains I face, I know that your love always wins every single day. Use me, God, to share your truth with each and every one I meet. Help me to be bold and strong and live it out in my life so there is no question of your goodness and grace. Thank you, Lord, for who you are and your never-ending love for me. In Jesus' name, amen. Now go and be brave like the tiny mustard seed. Move mighty mountains by faith so others may come to believe. This book is based off the parable in Matthew 17:20, to God be the glory. You don't have enough faith, Jesus told them. I tell you the truth, if you have faith even as small as a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it would move. Nothing would be impossible. Did you know that a mustard seed is one of the smallest seeds in the world, measuring 1 to 2 millimeters in size? The tiny seed will grow into a large bush that can be more than 30 feet tall. Jesus uses this special seed for numerous stories in the Bible to show that the power of God can be found in the smallest of things.